On hot copy this morning, we have the Vice Chair of the House Committee on Banks and Financial Intermediaries, Representative Joey Salceda. Congressman Salceda, good morning.
Good morning.
All right, thank you for joining me. I know that you have an update, updated draft of House Bill 6398. How has your draft improved? Can you take us through details of your draft?
It was 3 days of continuous deliberations, Karen. So I'd rather go through exactly what are the concerns.
Go ahead. So first, the concerns first with the sovereign wealth fund are transparency issues. Earlier discussed is the lack of power of the lower courts to actually stop an investment of the fund. So have you included certain changes in your draft?
Yung concern kasi niyan, ang pinakamalaking concern ay yung comparison sa IMDb, no. I will address that concern later, no. Kasi nga hindi naman namin nilagay yun kasi ang dami ng jurisprudence which essentially prevents you know the national government from implementing its programs. So hindi na namin, we did not see any need to put that particular provision in the most recent draft.
Okay, but why do we need a sovereign wealth fund today? Why should this be the priority, Congressman? Is it meant to raise more funds, earn more revenues for government? Why is the president pushing this?
The overall word is national development. Although the principal instrument is the General Appropriation Act, but the General Appropriation Act is essentially restricted by the fact that you have 306 congressmen with very parochial concerns. So, kailangan natin ng isang dedicated fund that will essentially be able to fund, let's say, big dams, national grids. Hindi natin basta-basta magagawa yan kasi pag dumana sa Kongreso, alam mo naman, every congressman wants something for his constituency. Mm-hmm. So the president saw it fit that there should be a particular fund that will earn, that will essentially be able to invest in national priority projects.
Okay, but the principle of a sovereign wealth fund is in a way it's invested abroad, so it earns more. And then you can use the funds for projects locally. What is your vision for this fund?
Well, there are certain principles on how these funds operate, but wala namang ganong klaseng restriction na you can only invest abroad or you can only invest locally. Ito po ay pera ng bayan. At ito ay isa pera po sa dito essentially ang magka-capitalize initially would be GSIS with 125 billion, SSS with 50, Land Bank with 50, DBP with 25, and the national government with 25.
Okay, so very quick questions for you, Congressman. GSIS and SSS are private funds. They are funds of pensioners, private individuals who contribute to these funds for their retirement, for their security. Does the law even allow you to use those funds? For example, I'm a member of SSS. What makes you think I want my money used for a sovereign wealth fund? Does the law allow you to use private people's funds in a government sovereign wealth fund?
Because these shares, investments in the sovereign wealth fund will be guaranteed by the national government. And therefore, it has potential to earn, but it has no risk.
But then how could you guarantee? I'll give you an example. The GSIS is $125 billion, and yet you don't have money right now to pay health workers delayed allowances and salaries. Hindi nila mapagkunan ng pondo. So where will you get the fund to guarantee?
Magkaiba naman ata. Yung isa ay national government. Yung isa naman GSIS. Let me give you the rundown. No, GSIS as financial investments of 1.3 trillion financial. The SSS has 702 billion. Land Bank has 2.9 trillion in investable funds. DBP has 1.15 trillion in investable funds. So what we're merely trying to do is to really just combine these funds so that it can invest in bigger projects, and there will be economies of scale, and they will be able to diversify, because economies mo nagsabi na under the current rules, they are restricted, and therefore their yields are actually very low. Like puro yan below 6%. Halimbawa ang SSS, JSIS, it's only Land Bank that's earning 14.7%. That's able to earn on their financial investments.
Okay, so first question, Congressman, is there is no law that actually bars the use of GSIS and SSS funds for the sovereign wealth fund. Members do not need to be consulted.
Well, may batas tayo kung naglalagak sa kung sino sa board, at saka meron naman silang mga risk management structure, which essentially based sa kanila pong sa kanilang decision, sa kanilang decision, eh pwede sila mag-invest po dito.
Okay. Is it even the best time to have a sovereign wealth fund? Yes. Norway, for example, I wanted to ask you, Norway is the world's largest sovereign wealth fund. It's the model for sovereign wealth funds in terms of transparency. It just lost $174 billion in the first half of the year. And that's already Norway. They can cushion the loss, but can the Philippines handle a loss like that?
Siyempre, pag kung we will take it out of context, can we lose 174 billion? Siyempre, we cannot afford it.
Yes.
Pero dito naman kasi, if you look at the management structure, the way it was drafted, there is a board of directors headed by the president, there's an advisory board, there's a risk management unit, and there's a joint congressional oversight committee.
But Congressman, is there a particular sovereign wealth fund that is doing well at the moment in Asia that we can model from? Malaysia clearly is, it's the what not to do, right? That's the bad case example of corruption, scandal, nepotism in a sovereign wealth fund.
Hindi mangyayari yun dito, dahil yung nangyari sa Malaysia, eh talaga, unang-una pinag-aralan na ko na mga igi yun, yung 1MDB, subsidiary lang yun ng GOCC, ng tinatawag nilang Ministry of Finance Inc. So yung para may Department of Finance, tapos gumawa ng sariling corporation at may subsidiary ng GOCC. So ang ginawa nung 1MDB, essentially, dahil siya po ay government-owned at under siya ng DOF, yung DOF, syempre, siya nagbibigay po ng guarantee. So, labas-labas siya ng labas ng pera. So, they keep issuing government-guaranteed bonds. So, hindi po yan mangyayari dito.
Oo. Anong kaibahan nun? I mean, considering nagamit po ang Malaysian fund for actually laundering money.
Kasi namantangin mo ang DOF.
Mm-mm.
Sa ilalim ng DOF, may maliit sila MFI Inc., Ministry of Finance Inc. Sa ilalim no, yun ay may-ari po siya ng 1MDB.
So maliit ang layering. Ang sinasabi niyo, maliit ang layering.
Naka-layer na naka-layer na at hindi napansin at nagising na lang sila, ang laki-laki na pala nung at saka yung 1MDB was able to invest in accounts that appeared legitimate but were actually the personal accounts of government officials of Malaysia.
Okay, so number one, you're saying the sovereign wealth fund, which will be called the Maharlika Wealth Fund, won't have any kind of layering. So it will have a board, and the board coming from different sectors, private, government, etc., they will be deciding on where to invest this fund, correct?
Yeah, and it's chaired by the president himself.
Okay, is it good that it's chaired by the president himself? You have observers asking, does it actually benefit the fund? Number one, given the history of the president's family, there are trust issues in terms of handling a fund like that. Number two, fears that it could be used for laundering. Go ahead, sir, go ahead.
Pero ito naman eh merong ano eh advisory board composed of the economic managers, may risk management unit, at may conjoint congressional oversight committee. So I think there are enough safeguards against any 1MDB scenario for the Maharlika Investment Fund.
Okay, what about the alleged conflict of interest that's been brought up by opposition lawmakers with the president possibly heading the fund?
I don't see, because the president is the head of NEDA, so he's in charge of the whole country actually, so he's the chief executive.
Okay, now there are concerns in terms of, for example, the details, as I think the European Chamber of Commerce in an interview has said, the devil is in the details. So the house, right.
Pagayin muna nila. Hindi pa nga nila pag-aralan na puputak na sila.
Okay. So if they say the devil is in the details, Congressman, what safeguards are you putting in the fund to make sure that everything is clear once it is implemented? I guess, like, for example, let's go through something.
I can send you an entire paper, yeah, which I really work out, being, you know, the technical working group. Well, number one, only government financial institution in preferring convertible debt instruments are government guaranteed. So nobody else is government guaranteed. Okay. The GFIs are fully owned by NG, making the government guarantee self-contained.
Okay.
Debt issued to other parties will not be government guaranteed. The Maharlika Fund has several layers of accountability from the board of directors, the advisory board, the risk management unit, and the congressional. The president is the chair of the board, unlike in Malaysia, you know, and itinago nila sa
ilalim. And there will be no politicians in the board?
The president is a politician.
Yes, no, the president, but the members of the board. There will be no politicians. No one.
Tingnan natin yung membership ng board. The membership in the board is based on essentially yung the will be proportional. The president we shall sit as a chairperson. The head of the GFIs with the most capital will be the vice chair.
Okay.
The rest shall sit as regular members in accordance with their corresponding shares or equity investment. There will be three independent directors, one from the private sector, one from the academe, and possibly one from I think basically, I was trying to insist because this is still an evolving document, but of course, ito na halos yung document, I was trying to insert the people's organization, for example.
Yeah,
so a collateral here that all members of the board of directors shall be citizens of the Philippines, at least 35, good moral standing, recognized probity, substantial experience and expertise in corporate governance, investment in financial asset, management of investment in global and local markets. So I don't know how a people's organization will help.
Okay. All right. That's good. So number two is, do you believe this will actually answer transparency issues when it comes to the fund?
I think so.
Okay. Number three, what was discussed between you and Congresswoman Stella Kimbo? What about not allowing the lower courts to stop a fund investment? Can we talk about that? And you yourself didn't agree with that.
Meron kasing, there was a suggestion during the TWG, which is very public, you know. Di ko akalain na may media pala doon. While I was making all those naughty comments. But basically, there is already enough jurisprudence which says that this fund cannot be stopped in the lower court, by the lower courts.
Mm-mm. And you'd want that in the draft? Do you need to have that in the draft?
There was a, no, not me. There was a suggestion to put it in a draft, but there was a legal there because it was a huge group, you know, looking into the draft. And they said it's not, no longer necessary.
Okay. So what if the investments go wrong? You said there was a guarantee, but clearly there has to be some strategy into using the money. So what's the vision for the fund? Where is it supposed to be invested in? Is there a target in terms of revenues to be raised by creating this fund?
There's the usual allowable investment, cash, foreign currency, fixed investment instrument issued by sovereigns, quasi-sovereigns. So, kita niyo kaagad. High-grade domestic and foreign corporate bonds, listed equities, financial, etc. And of course, loans and guarantees to or participation into joint ventures or consortium with Filipino and foreign investor, whether in the majority or minority position in commercial, industrial, mining, agriculture, housing, energy, which are essentially the, this actually reflect the priorities of the president. Pag nangyari ka dyan, kasi dyan sa house, pag nagbigay ka ng pera na napakalaki, tapos ang absorptive capacity nung ng ating pong mga departments eh mapagal eh napupunta sa iba. So natsa-chop-chop yung ang kailangan ng presidente ay isang dedicated fund that over time habang in, so na halimbawa he wanted a grid.
Yeah.
He wanted a dam. When was the last time we built a big dam? San Roque in 1994. That was ready for 30 years ago. Those are the things, the kind of things that this fund will invest in.
Okay, but then are there parameters other than that's an infrastructure project? But for example, the recent one, no, the fund, the sovereign wealth fund from Norway, for example, it invested in equity and equity investments dipped 17%. Fixed income investments also dipped 9%.
Ayoko magsalita kasi tungkol sa Norway kasi they're investing $10 billion in the Philippines.
Yeah, but then they're also investing in energy infrastructure. It also dipped.
Yeah,
so ang tanong ko, will this fund have parameters on where to invest?
Ang parameters is where they can invest. And of course, it depends really on the function and the power of the board of directors.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, to be fair to this administration, it is not the first time this has been suggested.
In August 2021.
Yeah, former Senator Bam Aquino. Well, also, go ahead.
Not just that. There was a draft already of a bill that was supposed to be sent to Congress of $30 billion. It's called the Banco Central Investment. It's called BIFC. So that was in August 2021. It was bigger, 30 billion times.
And who actually drafted that? If it's 2021,
came from the Banco Central.
Just for our viewers in context, former Senator Bam Aquino during the Aquino administration also recommended a fund, a sovereign wealth fund. I think also Senator J.V. Ejercito filed a bill for a sovereign wealth fund during the next administration. So a sovereign wealth fund, the suggestion of it isn't new. That's the context. So now, Congressman, why didn't it work before? Why didn't it fly? Because right now, it's already past the committee level, and the likelihood of this passing the House, they say, is by December 14. Is that correct?
December 12.
Exactly. So it didn't work during the other administrations. What happened then, and what is happening now?
Because we did not put our minds to it. And then essentially, because that is really this is the biggest move of this president, actually the first biggest move of this president, to really come up with a fund that is dedicated to investing in projects of the highest priority in national development.
Mm-hmm.
He wants this fund to work, and he wants this fund immediately.
Okay, now there has to be some kind of a growth model you're looking at once the fund is already put in place. It's invested in the first year. Do you have a figure, Congressman? You're an expert in this, in terms of financial growth.
Kung ano lang, definitely kung ito pong yung mga, yung kung titinan lang natin yung tatlo, yung GSIS, SS Land Bank, kailangan at DBP, dapat it should go more than 6%.
Okay.
But the order rate is 7.7%.
Okay.
Definitely, titingnan nila yung mga projects that will bring, and for Land Bank, it's actually 14.7%.
Yeah, I'm curious, can the Sovereign Wealth Fund of the Philippines, will you allow it to invest in U.S. stocks, for example, upstarts in the United States? We do know that there's a lot of money there too. Big losses, but big earnings. For example, can it invest in Apple? Can it invest in Samsung? Does the Sovereign Wealth Fund of the Philippines, can it work that way?
Para sa akin kasi, it's up to the board. Pero
okay.
Pero I think the presidential guidance really is to invest in national development.
All right. And investing in projects in the Philippines, while of course it's something the country needs, but how will the fund work, earn from investing within the country?
Because unang-una, marami tayong PPP. So yan ay may mga revenue may mga revenue generating capacity po yan, karamihan po dyan. Kasi wala namang PPP na walang revenues. Pangalawa, marami, there's a huge demand versus the supply, let's say, of water. And therefore, I think definitely demand is bigger than supply. Usually the returns are high. So pagdating sa electricity, we have the same, especially in renewables. Yeah. Kaya nga kanina sinasabi ko sa iyo, hindi ako makapagsalita tungkol sa Norway because these are my friends and they are investing $10 billion in the Philippines in renewables. Of course, sometimes it loses, but at least for dito, sa funds na to, yung funding GFIs, they are protected. I mean, the pensioners are protected, SSS is protected, but they have the upside because definitely by pooling the resources of the investable resources of GSIS, SSS, Land Bank, and DBP, as well as was continuous investment by the national government, ang idea kasi dito, 50% ng dividends ng Land Bank ipapasok dito, 10% ng PAGCOR, from their gross gaming revenues will be invested here annually thereafter. And of course, I think at least $50 billion a year from the General Appropriations Act will be invested in the fund. So we will be able to have the economies of scale to invest in these vital and critical national development projects.
Okay. All right. My last question, just to close. I mean, of course, there's still a draft. There's a paper I actually read before our interview last night, and it actually states six reasons why Sovereign Wealth Fund should not invest or be invested at home, meaning the fund itself. Of course, the income of the fund is another story, right? So do you really believe that the fund, if spent at home, because as it is, there is limited income. I mean, I invest in a fund in the Philippines and it's nothing like what funds earn when they're invested in the US or in other countries. So do you believe that's the wisest thing too for that fund?
Well, itong fund kasi kasama naman nasa mga allowable investments naman yung pag-invest abroad.
Okay.
Pero ang guidance po dito is really that President Bongbong wanted this fund to invest in dams, in grids, in renewables. And these are very, I think, should result not just in national development, but of course in higher yields for the fund itself. So wala namang ano eh, it is debatable whether a fund should only invest abroad.
Okay.
For diversification, di ba?
All right. Okay. Because, Okay, my last question to those criticizing the fund. The essence they say of a sovereign wealth fund is it's extra budgetary, meaning you have excess funds. What do you say to those critics who say we don't have the money?
Pa-approve pa lang sa Indonesia, puno din ng utang at puno din ng deficit, mas mataas pa nga kaysa sa atin. Pero kalalabas pala ng sovereign wealth fund nila. Ang issue dito is that GSIS, SSS, Land Bank, and DBP have investable funds which can be mobilized for national development.
All right. On that note, is there anything you would like to add, Congressman? So you believe this will be passed by December 12 or before?
They're working very hard. That's why when Franz Castro said, have you talked to the pensioner and explained to them, say, we will make a presentation, I think, on Monday morning.
So you will make a presentation to GSIS and SSS pensioners?
Yes, as well as all the others. Of DBP. But they will essentially understand that they are protected. At the same time, they will have that chance, the opportunity to partake or to participate in the upside of this fund.
Okay, and you're expecting smooth sailing in the Senate too, frankly speaking?
Ibang istorya na yan. Kasi my experience really is that I hope and pray.
All right. On that note, Congressman Joey Salceda, have a Merry Christmas, sir. I'll see you again soon.
Thank you very much and good morning.
Good morning.